Let's think about exponents with ones and zeros. So let's take the number 1 and let's raise it to the 8th power. So we've already seen that there's two ways of thinking about this. You could literally view this as taking 8 ones and then multiplying them together. So let's do that. So you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 ones, and then you're going to multiply them together. And if you were to do that, you would get, well, 1 times 1 is 1 times 1. It doesn't matter how many times you multiply 1 by 1. You are going to just get 1. You are just going to get 1. And you could imagine, I did it 8 times. I multiplied 8 ones. But even if this was 80, or if this was 800, or if this was 8 million, if I just multiplied 1, if I had 8 million ones, and I multiplied them all together, it would still be equal to 1. So 1 to any power is just going to be equal to 1. You would say, hey, what about 1 to the 0th power? 1 to the 0th power. Well, we've already said anything to the 0th power, except for 0, it's actually up for debate. But anything to the 0th power is going to be equal to 1. And just as a little bit of intuition here, you could literally view this as our other definition of exponentiation, which is you start with a 1, and this number says how many times you're going to multiply that 1 times this number. So 1 times 1, 0 times, is just going to be 1. And that was a little bit clearer when we did it like this, where we said 2 to the, let's say, 4th power, 2 to the 4th power, is equal to, this was the other definition of exponentiation we had, which is you start with a 1, and then you multiply it by 2 4 times. So times 2, times 2, times 2, times 2, which is equal to, let's see, this is equal to 16. So here, if you start with a 1, and then you multiply it by 1 0 times, you're still going to have that 1 right over there. And that's why anything that's not 0 to the 1 power is going to be equal to 1. Now let's try some other interesting scenarios. Let's try some negative numbers. So let's take negative 1, and let's first raise it to the 0 power. So once again, this is just going based on this definition. This is starting with a 1, and then multiplying it by this number 0 times. Well, that means we're just not going to multiply it by this number, so you're just going to get a 1. Let's try negative 1. Let's try negative 1 to the 1st power. Well, anything to the 1st power, you could view this, and I like going with this definition as opposed to this one right over here. If we were to make them consistent, if you were to make this definition consistent with this, you would say, hey, let's start with a 1, and then multiply it by 1 8 times. And you're still going to get a 1 right over here. But let's do this with negative 1. So we're going to start with a 1, and then we're going to multiply it by negative 1 1 time. Times negative 1, and this is, of course, going to be equal to negative 1. Now, let's take negative 1 and let's take it to the 2nd power. We often say that we are squaring it when we take something to the 2nd power. So negative 1 to the 2nd power. Well, we could start with a 1. We could start with a 1 and then multiply it by negative 1 2 times. Multiply it by negative 1. Multiply it by negative 1 twice. And what's this going to be equal to? And once again, by our old definition, you could also just say, hey, ignoring this 1, because that's not going to change the value, we took 2 negative 1s and we're multiplying them. Well, negative 1 times negative 1 is 1. And I think you see a pattern forming. Let's take negative 1. Let's take negative 1 to the 3rd power. To the 3rd power. What's this going to be equal to? Well, by this definition, you start with a 1, and then you multiply it by negative 1 3 times. So negative 1 times negative 1 times negative 1. Or you could just think of it as you're taking 3 negative 1s and you're multiplying it, because this 1 doesn't change the value. And this is going to be equal to negative 1 times negative 1 is positive 1 times negative 1 is negative 1. So you see the pattern. Negative 1 to the 0th power is 1. Negative 1 to the 1st power is negative 1. Then you multiply by negative 1 again to get positive 1. Then you multiply by negative 1 again to get negative 1. And the pattern you might be seeing is if you take negative 1 to an odd power, you're going to get negative 1. And if you take it to an even power, you're going to get 1. You're going to get 1, because a negative times a negative is going to be the positive, and you're going to have an even number of negatives, so you're always going to have negative times negatives. So this right over here, this is even. even is going to be positive 1. And you could see that if you went to negative 1 to the 4th power. Negative 1 to the 4th power. Well, you could start with a 1 and then multiply it by negative 1 4 times. So negative 1 times negative 1 times negative 1 times negative 1, which is just going to be equal to positive 1. So if someone were to ask you, we already established that if someone were to take 1 to the, 1 millionth power, this is just going to be equal to 1. It's just going to be equal to 1. If someone told you, let's take negative 1 and raise it to the 1 millionth power, 1 millionth power. Well, 1 million is an even number, so this is still going to be equal to positive 1. But if you took negative 1, to the 999,999th power, this is an odd number. So this is going to be equal to negative 1.